over the summer of 1939, the British government and the French government gave guarantees to Poland of Poland's independence. Then on the 1st of September, Hitler invaded Poland, and the 2 days later, on the 3rd of September, Neville Chamberlain instructed the British ambassador in Berlin to give Hitler an ultimatum that unless he immediately withdrew from Gdańsk and stopped his aggression against Poland, then there would be war between Britain and Germany.
This morning, the British ambassador in Berlin handed the German government a final note stating that unless we heard from them by 11 o'clock, that they were prepared at once to withdraw their troops from Poland, a state of war would exist between us.
World War II begins for Britain on the morning of the 3rd of September 1939 with Chamberlain's address to the British people by radio, where he announced that the ultimatum that he had delivered to Germany had been ignored and that consequently Britain was at war with Germany. That was the culmination of a long period of diplomacy, and failed diplomacy ultimately.
And at that point, the mood in Britain had very much changed from what it had been the previous year. The cabinet, the House of Commons, and I think the population at large realised that there was no alternative to war, although I don't think anybody wanted war. They were certainly not against it. They saw there was no alternative.
Well, before September 1939, there was a great deal of nervousness. People, the population of the United Kingdom remembered the horrors of the First World War, and by September 1939, something like 38 million gas masks had been issued to the population. And you can imagine what that must have felt like for families at home to see, to really feel the fear of aerial bombardment and mass gas attacks on the population.